Welcome to the Pilgrims Project.
Hey people, it's a pilgrim, and welcome to the Cathedral of the Fire Wyvern. I'm on Valguero, just above the waterfall where the entrance to the underground sea is. Just above that waterfall is like a small lake surrounded by the cliffs, and I thought it'd be a great place for a castle, you know, to have the waterfall run underneath it. If you had a tech transmitter as well, it'd make a pretty good place for a water dino pen. Anyway, I got looking at some Gothic castles, churches, cathedrals, stuff like that. And I really wanted to try and get that sort of imposing Gothic look with this build. So I wanted like really tall windows with flying buttresses holding up the stonework around them. And I just started building and the whole place turned into more of the sort of a cathedral than a castle, I reckon. I wanted to get some like bronze metal work into the build. So I used metal dino gateways for the windows and some metal structures that are built into the tower. And I also use metal catwalks to sort of tie everything together. Sort of runs underneath all the roof sections between all the buttresses and everything and sort of holds all the windows together as well. That's how I built the second lot of dino doors on top of the first lot. Sort of ran the catwalks across and then put the fence foundations onto the catwalks. But I'll show you that in the build. Ended up spraying them all orange just because it had like a darker, richer colour to it than like the cantle open stuff like that. Had more of a bronzy colour. The whole build took around 30 hours. Once I figured out how to sort of build the windows and the buttresses, it's just a matter of repeating that, you know, in the structures and the two wings on each side of the tower. It's to build like a big glass dome with the buttresses holding it up and maybe even some actually inside it, you know, running through it. But I had to sort of run the wing, this left-hand wing of the building, with the roof. I had to be sort of run into something, if you know what I mean, to sort of hide the roof sections instead of it just being like a flat door again. So I built this whole like rounded section there that supports the dome on top. Inside there, I've just put like crop plots and stuff and made it into a bit of a farm. It looks really good. And there's like a stone staircase that goes right the way around the outside. And then on the interior is like a bronze metal spiral staircase with like crafting stations and stuff, but I'll show you that in a bit. I'll have a run around. The main tower's got like four floors that are accessible, and then the top portion I've built like a bell tower into it. You can see it here. I use water pipes and like the little metal water storage tank. And just at its at different levels, and they do actually look like bells hanging down off the ropes. It's pretty cool. So I was quite happy with how that turned out. And I just used the different artifacts just to get a bit of colour and something different into it. But yeah, it looks cool. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. The rest of the metal that I used just sort of ties the whole thing together, like the pillars and everything. The taller the structure gets, the more sort of support it needs. And you can see the two wings next to the tower sort of cross shaped as well, and that's how most like cathedrals and churches were actually constructed, just like the tower in the center. But yeah, I think it worked out really well. I'm dead happy with it. I'll have a quick run around the interior and just show you what I did with it, why it's called the Cathedral of the Fire Wyvern. Right, you can go and take a look around the interior. You sort of see how big it is to scale now while I'm running around. There's tons of room underneath the place. You'll see it when you sort of watch the building side of the video. There's loads of walls that are like four high where you could get a dino gate in and get all your dinosaurs underneath the place, you know, underneath all this metal floor in here. Anyway, this is why it's called the Church of the Fire Wyvern, because I was just looking for a way to sort of decor the place and sort of fill it up. I just used like a giant taxidermy stand there and put some rugs, tables running through it, and then put some rugs over it and some of the small storage boxes around it. And just built like a little bit of a church section here with the benches. I've got clip active, no mods, so that's why everything's sort of can cut into it, everything. And you sort of get the idea what I was going for here with these big open long spaces, dead tall. Like the butchers are supposed to be holding the building up from the outside, so you can have these big like stained glass windows, letting all the light in. This section here, that was just like a bit of a crafting area at the bottom. This middle bit's like a bit of a cooking area. You sort of get a view of the place there. You'd have to kill the dragon boss a lot of times to get all that decor together. But it looked pretty good. And this top bit's just dino storage. There's a bunch of tech generators dotted around the place inside the roofs and stuff. That's why there's no wiring running everywhere. And then this is the glass dome in the top. Like I said, I just built it into a bit of a farm. Put some crop plots in. And you've got some pretty decent views from up here as well. But yeah, it just needed something different on the end of this wing, I think. And I had enough room to build this dome. And I did want a glass dome somewhere in it. And it just looked better than just having like another flat gateway, you know what I mean, on the end. And then, yeah, going back down, there's like this stone spiral staircase runs right around the outside of the building. Goes back inside here a little bit so you can get into the roof and then down. And then I just built like a couple of ways to get into it from the ground level as well, because there's a pathway just behind where we are now next to the lake. The pathway goes up into the mountain a little bit and then back down to the lowlands. So you could have like another dino gate on that end, behemoth gate or something, just to block the area off. There it is, got the flying buttresses on the outside. There's like four of them holding it up, and then the glass dome on top. There's a lot of symmetry in this build. Having clip active was great because you just like run everything straight into the landscape. Made it a lot easier. And there is a ton of room out here as well if you really wanted a dino pen. You know, get your transmitter, stick all your water dinos in it, and then just drop them back off up here, out of the way. There wasn't much room to fit much else in at this side, because it was right up against the rocks, so I just built like a small tower with another small bell tower above it. And just painted them doors in that orange bronze colour as well. Big metal doors, looks good. And just put some vaults and stuff. I was going to fill this whole section with like, pews, just all the seating for a church, and put another altar at the end. But I didn't want to do the same thing on both sides. So I'll just leave that one to your imagination. And this is one of the new chalk golems. So I'll just put like the transmitter down here to bring some of the dinos inside. And yeah, some cryopods and stuff. Just the essentials, really. There's the view out of the place. It is really an excellent spot, this, I think. I always try and build like cool stuff. There's no stuff that's pretty unique, but it's always got like a purpose and a reason. This base is just really elaborate. I just built it purely for the aesthetics. Just after looking at some of the buildings that I'd seen in real life and everything, I was wondering if I could actually pull it off in the game. And yeah, I think I did a pretty good job of it, to be honest. That was just a little throne there I built on the bottom floor of the tower. And then this is just built like just living quarters, really. Yeah, I just built this one because I wanted to see what it looked like. More than anything, if I could sort of pull it off, the idea I sort of had in my head. I was just sort of building, just building for building's sake, and sort of putting this place together bit by bit. So I wasn't really considering how big the rooms would be inside the tower or what I'd do with them, to be honest. But I think they worked out okay. Definitely needed like plenty of glass in the tower, and I've got built some balconies on it. There's a couple you can get outside onto. Just there, and then that's the whole tower going straight into where the bells are. Sort of see down onto the both wings from up here. See where I run all the metal catwalks, like right along the roofs and inside everything. Yeah, need some rope ladders in there. Could have had some ropes coming down from the bells as well, that would have been good. And there we go, guys. That's the top, well, as far up the tower as you can get, pretty much. It was a really long build. It was like 8 days to build, and do the recording as well and get the editing done. So it was a long one. Yeah, speed build next. So if you're sticking around to watch that, it's a long one. It's about 2.5 hours long. But I really couldn't condense it anymore without missing some major chunks out. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the build, guys. I'd love to see some comments and stuff and see what people think about it. It'd be great. Other than that, yeah, enjoy the rest of the video and I will catch you later. Thanks for watching.
Valguero.